Good evening.
Good evening.
I greet each and everyone gathered here this evening with joy of optimism, of purpose and service. Here we meet as a family which believes wholeheartedly in the vision, the purpose and the work of the labor movement, and as a family which continues to hold fast to the creed that we impact the lives of all. For the good we can do. With general elections looming large on the national frontier, the time both is right and ripe for us to come aside as a people of purpose, that we may rub shoulders and draw inspiration from each other as comrades. We meet here this evening to connect as we commit our hearts and hands to the works of community development, national building, one heart at one mind at a time. Each of us present here and now represent thousands of lives that we desire to lift from poverty and uncertainty, that prosperity which is undergirded by vision, commitment, and industry. And even though we are not here to launch a campaign or candidacy as yet, we are here to stand in solidarity with boys and girls in our school, the men working on the roadside verges and on the construction sites across this island, and many women working on the industrial estates and in our homes. We are here to pledge to the people working in the public sector, the troubled teachers, the neglected nurses, the politicized police officers, the push-around permanent secretaries, all who continue to be stifled as workers under an unfair regime. That is why this evening we come to this announcement which formally declares to the people that I, Geoffrey Ian Hanley, have been chosen to lead the work of the Labour Party here in constituency number 1, and that I hope they accept this mandate in a sense of purpose and promise. And in turn, I stand and declare in my acceptance of oneness of purpose with all persons here present, as well as with all people of St. Christopher number 1 and all nationals of St. Kitts and Nevis living home and abroad. I humbly ask each person here present to take this good news to your homes, on your jobs, and everywhere you go. Take the message that Geoffrey has accepted the call to serve with four simple yet significant words. Let everyone know that Geoffrey has said, yes, I am with you. The theologically astute among us would readily identify those words, having come from the 10th verse of the 41st chapter of the book of Isaiah, where the prophet of God presented these unfailing words of the Lord to the people of Israel. Here at the start of the journey to Victory East Bastia, I say these words to you and the people of Newtown, Ponds Pasture, Ponds Extension, and Ponds Estate, Gillard, Millard, Mellows, and Taylors, Burnrock and Frigate Bay, the South East Peninsula. Do not be afraid. I am natural. But I say this to you as a sign of my deep and abiding commitment to all the people born of the spirit of comradery, of understanding and of emotional intelligence needed to meaningfully impact the lives of our people. Leave here tonight knowing that all these words are not newly found in my life. For all along the way, they have shaped who I have become as a person, as a community leader, and as a friend of the people. I make this commitment here before you because of the positive impact of the comrades of labor on my life over the years. I recall in my formative years, sitting at the feet of Comrade Ina Fifield and Comrade Ralph Toto and others who worked the list of Newtown and East Bastia with a passion that they never flirted. They never thought I was too young to join the cause of the masses, and I am grateful. I also recall fondly Comrade Anne Leibold, the late mother of our party deputy leader, how she organized Easter camps for us as children of the Labour Party. These comrades and others stood with me and were among the motivators that led me to a life of committed service to our great party. And just as they were with me, tonight I say to the people of Labour and East Bastia, I am with you. Many of you will not recall that as a child I was a slow learner in school. I started high school in the lower streams of the first form, but it was a direct result of the dedicated hard work of many teachers and my stepmother, the late Mrs. Hortense Hanley, who took the time to work with me, and that I am able to rise above the ordinary as a student. Tonight, as I look around, I see many of my teachers. I say thank you. Auntie Jill, I say thank you. Mrs. Gray, although I did not attend convent school, I ran away several times, and you assisted me in English and geography. I say thank you to my teachers. Mrs. Dolphin is not here, my scout leader. I say thank you to her. I did not become a teacher, nor did I become a youth director, graduate of a holder of a doctoral degree without benefiting from the hard work of my teachers and my parents. Recognizing this, I say here now, just like my teachers and my mother, when I say mothers, because my stepmother was always considered my mother as well, they were in my life making a difference. I say to the young people of this country, I am with you. I take this time to say a special thank you to Dr. Lincoln Carty, who assisted me with the completion of my dissertation. And because of my life experiences, I was able to receive that great award 3 days after the death of my mother from the SSU University. Dr. Carty, if you're here, I say thank you. In my long adult years, I would have had the opportunity to work closely with various ministers of youth. I am grateful to each one of them, including Ambassador Sam Condon, Ambassador Jacint Henry Martin, Mr. Glenn Phillip, and Honorable Sean Richards, for the ways they have offered me guidance and have broadened my scope of professional growth and personal development. Because I can only pay to forward, I say to the young professionals of East Bastia that just as those leaders were there for me in the past, Today I accept this role to lead this constituency, and I say I am with you. God knows I cannot ask for more supportive family. Starting with my beautiful wife, my loving wife, who showers me with the support, prayer and praise. To my three children, who are most adorable and supportive. My daddy, my hero, my rock, as well as my brothers and my sisters, my nieces and nephews, my godchildren, my great nieces, my great great nephews. I stand proudly this evening and I say thank you for following me this way in my journey. I thank God for the Four family, which continues to be the place I turn to for advice and peace of mind when all around seems to be chaotic. I truly am thankful that God has blessed me with such a caring, loving family. Can you give my family a round of applause, please? Comrades and friends, my family has been the example in my life of the model family that East Bastia will become once again. I commit that just as my family has been there with me, showing me love and how much they care, I say to all the families of constituency number one this evening, I am with you. I solemnly promise to work with the same passion and energy I gave when I started working with the party as a youth in elections of 1984. I promise to be as committed in serving the people as I have been as a scout leader, the deputy commissioner of scouts, and as a Lions Club member. I commit to deliver lasting avenues of empowerment to our people, just as I did when I helped to form the St. Kitts Nevis Youth Parliamentary Association, which today is a model youth organization in the Commonwealth Caribbean. I also promise that I will continue to identify areas of needs in this constituency and assist in the uplifting of others, as I have done in my elderly ministry and my prison education ministry. Tonight, as I accept the awesome responsibility to serve as Labour's leader in East Bastia, I say, just as I have been there for the people in the past, I solemnly declare with commitment and conviction, I will continue to be with you. If all were not enough of a case for the cause, I want each of us to join me in, as I ask you to think with me back at the last days of the life of my dear mother, the late Gertrude Lewis. While sitting with her one day, she said to me, clear and unmistakably tone, Geoffrey, if Dr. Douglas should ever ask you to run for the Labour Party, you run, my boy. The only thing is that I won't be around. Had no clue that she wouldn't. Know that my acceptance tonight and my commitment to you was first made by my mother. And because of that, it is an oath I take most seriously. And so, just like I have no desire to break my word with my dear loving mother, who was there for me and all of her children, never failing, never faltering, to each of you I say, as the son of Mrs. Gertrude Lewis, I am with you. The road ahead will not be easy, be an easy one, comrades. The victory ahead will ask of each of us to be committed to the cause of people's empowerment and community development and nation building. It begs of us that we must all make available our lives, our time, our talents and resources to making the campaign, which will soon unveil a successful one. As your constituency leader, I know I can count on each of you present here to join in this effort to continue the growth and change here in our East Marseille community and in our country. So I look forward to receiving your advice and your words of counsel, as well as your complaints. I also count on your willing financial support that will help to get much work done. And while I count on you, I shall in turn hold fast to my commitment that I am with you. Tonight we begin a new chapter, thankful for the workforce of Comrade Earl Asim Martin, a leader in this constituency for the past 25 years. I end by thanking him and his team of committed workers for having transformed our community. Yet I can choose no better way to thank Dr. Martin than to offer to you, the people, leadership that motivates and empowers. I know this will make him proud. Once again, thank you, Dr. Earl Asim Martin. Comrades and friends, there is work ahead for all of us to do. I invite each of you to become more and more active in the work of the party in East Marseille community in months ahead. Let us make a difference by knocking on each door, by shaking each hand and touching each life for the better, knowing that everyone is important. To my church leadership and members, Apostle and Prophetess Michael and Shireen Moses, thank you for your prayer, advice, and release. My church family, you have nothing to fear. He will continue to be with me. Many of you witnessed the many prophecies that God wants me to serve in this capacity at this time. I will be a true ambassador for our Lord. No one will change me from what God has purposed me to be. Thank you also to all of our supporting pastors who are here with us this evening. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Allow God to move. I know, ladies and gentlemen, comrades, I am not responsible for the formal vote of thanks, but please allow me to say thank you once again to my church family and the prayer warriors and the intercessors, to Mrs. Viola Grant and the staff of the Royal St. Kitts Resort, JACTA, for the accommodation, to my event committee team. Wow, you blew me away. I can't wait for the launch. To my beautiful wife and her catering team, I say thank you. All those persons who traveled from overseas to be here with me, I say thank you. A special thank you is extended to my primary school principal, Mrs. Clark. I think I will ask her to stand at this time. Mrs. Clark, thank you, thank you, thank you. To my family again, I say thank you. I look forward to greater support. To my dad, thanks for the surprise. My sisters and my nieces, Natasha, my dear, and my oldest niece is here, Andrea. Thank you. But Tasha flew all around the world just to be here this evening and is leaving tomorrow. I am extremely grateful for that love, Natasha. Thank you very much. To the musicians, the DJ, everyone, I say thank you. And I close by telling you again, have no fear because